Hello, everyone. Today, I will be showing you how to add store policies and legal pages on Shopify. If you have watched our tutorials in the past, you probably own a business or are building a Shopify store. If you decide that you would like to have your store taken off your hands so you can just focus on the business, then you need to check out our Sales Accelerator Program. This program uses online advertising to increase sales on your website. The link to the Sales Accelerator Program, you can find it in the description below. And as always, if you haven't already subscribed, make sure that you hit that button and hit the bell so you know when we actually drop more videos and more tutorials. Let's get into it. All right, so the first thing we wanna do is on your Shopify dashboard, we're gonna click on Settings. And then from here, we're gonna go to the very last one, which says legal. In here, you'll find the refund policy, privacy policy, terms of service, and shipping policy. Now, the easiest way to do this would be to hit on this button that says create from template. This would automatically fill out your policies in here with, and then it will actually add some of the information from your store, things that you have already set up. For example, your email address, you'll see that here, hello@bitbranding.co. And you'll also, in some cases, see your store address listed in here. So be very careful if you have maybe a home address listed in your store. Maybe it's not listed anywhere else. Maybe that's where you're shipping your products from. This will add that address as part of the legal jargon on some of these pages. So you definitely want to go over this and make sure that your address, your home address, is not listed in here. I think a quick thing that you could do would be to click somewhere here on the text and hit Command F or Control F if you're on a PC, and then search for your maybe your zip code or your city. This place, maybe Texas, and we see that here under this template, which is the privacy policy, we have our full address listed in here. This is our office here at BitBranding. So I don't really mind having that on the privacy policy page. But again, if you are shipping from home, you don't want your home address displayed everywhere, then I would do a Command F to search for your address. And then you can just click and delete that. You will also see that some of these templates, obviously they're kind of generic. So one, you definitely wanna go over them and make sure that whatever information is listed in here makes sense for your page. And then on top of that, you'll see this one, for example, has things that are capitalized and in brackets. And that's information for you to either add or subtract, depending on, again, the type of technology that you're using on your website, for example, on this section right here. And then some of the other things would be insert any other type of payments that you accept if they're not listed within here. So some stores have, for example, I think Aftership, where clients can actually go in and pay in installments. That will be something to include in here because that won't be automatically added to the privacy policy and different things like that. So after you create from template and comb through those, make sure that you delete anything that has either brackets, or make sure you add the actual information that they're asking you to add in there. And then after you create all these, and again, you always wanna make sure that you read through some of these, and make sure that all the information there is accurate for your store. And then the last one is the shipping policy. The shipping policy doesn't have a create from template, but this should be a pretty simple and straightforward where you're just basically having a sentence or two about how long it takes to process orders, what's the lead time and things like that. So it could literally be just two or three sentences where you're talking about your shipping policy. So after you added all of those and when you make your changes, you can click save. When you save these will automatically be added to your cart and checkout pages, but they won't be added anywhere else on your store. So it's very important to go back to settings. Actually, we're gonna go to online store. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna add them to the navigation. So under online store, you'll see navigation in here. We're gonna add them to the footer menu. And we can do that by clicking on the title footer menu. And then in here, we're gonna add menu item. And then we're gonna look for policies. So once you add the policies, you actually have a link in there for policies, and you'll see our three policies. So we can do the privacy policy. If you click on the link first, it will automatically give you the name. so you don't have to change that. So add policies, the refund policy, add, and then policies, terms of service, add. And there we go. Now we have all of our policies listed on the footer menu of our website. Now, if you have an additional policy, for example, let's say that because of COVID, you need to add maybe a health prevention page to talk about what are some of the things that you're doing to ensure your customer safety, then you can do that by just manually adding a page. So you will go to pages, and then in here you can add page, click on add page, and do something like COVID-19 guidelines. And then in here within the text, just write your text on what are your guidelines that you're using right now for COVID. You wanna click save on that. And again, go back to the navigation, look for that page and add it to your footer. All right, and there you have it. That's how you can quickly add some privacy policies, guidelines, legal pages to your website and how to add them to the navigation. All right, thank you for watching our video on how to add policies to your Shopify store. If you enjoyed this video, make sure that you hit that like button and subscribe so you don't miss out on any of our new tutorials. And as always, if you have any questions, just let us know in the comments below and we'll make sure to answer them for you.